Hello YouTube, how's it going? Today, I am cooking pigs in blankets. Now, this is the first time that I have experimented with what I'm about to do. Before, I have made it on the video. Most of the time, I just wing it and do it. But anyway, the experiment revealed some interesting things to me. Because the way that you traditionally make a pig in a blanket, it's really easy. You take a hot dog, you get some Pillsbury crescent rolls, and you roll it up in it, and you can add some cheeses if you want. And that's that. You bake it. Well, I've discovered some things, first of all. You gotta bake it for way longer than the actual amount of time that you would take to just bake the crescent rolls. Also, the cheese spilled out. It melted and came out everywhere. So, I have had to decide a new way to encompass the cheese so that it stays in things. So, let me show you what I'm doing. First of all, got my crescent rolls there. That's what they look like before you turn them into crescents. And they're actually supposed to be divided in half along these hills. But, in order to keep the cheese in, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use two crescent roll things per hot dog. I'm using bigger hot dogs today. I'm using these giant Hebrew National hot dogs, as opposed to the smaller ones which I used before. And the way that I'm going to do it is instead of doing it diagonally, I'm actually going to make it so this giant hot dog is completely encompassed within the blanket and the cheese, and therefore there should be no escaping. So, here we go. So what you want to do is you want to get this nice and stretched out. Enough so that, you know, we can take our hot dog and encompass it so that it is completely covered. So, there you are. You can see that that hot dog is going to fit there. So then what we want to do is you want to take a little bit of cheese. Cheddar cheese, American cheese. Any of these cheeses will work fine. And you want to grate a little bit of cheese in there. So that is a little bit of cheese in there. And then what we're going to do is we're just going to roll this up. So you're rolling. And we're rolling. And we've got the cheese in the middle. And then we're going to stamp it down shut on that side. Stamp it down shut on that side. And just make sure that it is happy duty. Alright. So, there you have it. That is one Hebrew National giant hot dog pig in a blanket. Get that seam smushed down there. They are sitting, three piggies in a blanket sitting on the tray getting ready to be put in the oven. So what we want to do, preheat the oven 350 degrees. Then on the packet here of these here crescent rolls, it says 16 to 20 minutes. Now in my experiment, that was not enough time. And it wasn't that my oven wasn't hot enough, it just, when the hot dog's in the middle of the crescent roll, it somehow changes the properties of it and makes the crescent take longer to cook on the inside, but it cooks fine on the outside. So, cook it until it is golden brown. Now, I don't know how it's going to be.
I'm going to put it in. We're going to find out together. You and me. That's what it's all about. So I'm going to put these in. When they're ready, I'll tell you how much time it was. And it might be less time for you. It might be more time for you. But what you should do is cook till it's golden brown. And cook by eye. And by smell. And that's a better way to cook than by time. So, oven's preheated. Put them in the oven. And let you get the action shot. In they go. We'll see when they're ready. Hello, YouTube. So, the mystery has been solved. It's just taken roughly 30 minutes. What I did was, after about 15 minutes, I turned it around. Not like that around, but like that around. So, what used to be in the back of the oven is now in the front of the oven. And that seemed to work. So here they are. Taking them out of the oven right now. Get the action shot. Got my oven mitt. And we take them out of the oven. And look at those. Yeah. So. Those look beautiful. Nice and golden brown. They've risen up. We've got just a tiny bit of cheese leakage, which is okay. Before when I did it, the entire pan was just filled with molten cheese, and none of it was left over. Now I'm going to let these cool down for a little bit, and then I'll try the first bite on camera like always. And there we have it.
Well, hello YouTube. So, I am now going to try this here pig in a blanket. Now I'm gonna use a knife and fork because this one here is just really intense. And let's see. Oh boy, look at that there on the inside. Got some cheese. We'll put a little ketchup on it.